Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss the network monitoring and analytics capabilities of Anuta ATOM. ATOM has the collection capabilities to support data from disparate sources such as SNMP, streaming telemetry, SNMP traps, and syslog. Let's take a look at them. ATOM offers multiple SNMP MIBs out of the box. If there are specific requirements, then you can download it from the internet and upload it to ATOM. We support all the different MIBs that are there in the industry today with respect to the collection aspects. Using these MIBs, one can create collection profiles such as these. For example, I have picked one of the collection profiles here. We can choose the relevant MIBs from the list and go granular in terms of the audits that you want to enable under those MIBs. Once done, you can choose a collection frequency as well and apply this to a group of devices or resource pools. Similarly, ATOM supports streaming telemetry or model event telemetry from the major vendors. This again appears as a collection profile in ATOM, where you can set the streaming telemetry specific parameters, such as transport type, where ATOM supports gRPC and TCP, then the dial modes, and the packet encoding parameters. Then we get to choose from the numerous sensors that the vendor devices support. This has a tree structure, so one could choose the depth at which you want to derive this information, and also choose the frequency at which ATOM should receive this information. ATOM allows data retention for a long period of time. Since there are going to be millions of metrics that you may collect, we understand that the database size is something that you will be wary of. While ATOM's microservices-based architecture allows horizontal scaling of its components, including the database, ATOM also supports roll-up and downsampling of data to ensure optimal usage of database and for long-term storage. We also understand that you may not want to turn on certain sensors for all your devices or all your interfaces. This is where ATOM helps you to filter this out for specific resources, such as your WAN-facing interfaces, for example. Once done, this profile can be applied to the devices supporting streaming or model event telemetry. ATOM also supports SNMP traps as seen here. You can choose the devices and the platforms, and then choose the audits to be enabled for SNMP trap collection. When we select the audits, we can also make sure an alert is created on ATOM to trigger closed-loop automation use cases. The pop-up will guide us on how to configure the trap for alert generation. For example, here we have chosen the link up and link down audits. We can associate a severity to it and also compose a message that should appear when an alert is generated. Once done, we can save the profile and subscribe to provision the SNMP traps on the devices. As you can see here, the alerts have been generated in the global alerts window. Both link up and link down and other traps can be seen as alerts here. Similarly, for the syslog, you can choose the platform on the devices and then choose the event specs that you want to monitor. So as you can see here, we collect from different data sources. We then normalize this information and store it in our time series database. So what does ATOM do with all this collected information? This is where ATOM's network monitoring capabilities come into picture. ATOM offers out-of-the-box templates that will help you visualize various metrics that are collected through SNMP, streaming telemetry, and SNMP traps. As seen here, we are now in the device tree screen and we have chosen one of the devices. The monitoring tab will show all the default charts for the device and the pane here shows the different metrics that are available. Let us start with the templates. Templates are nothing but some of the out-of-the-box charts that network teams can readily start using. This includes device health, some of the interface-specific statistics, top-end reports, device and network health statistics, and much more. What you're seeing on the screen now is the device health statistics, such as CPU utilization at various time ranges, memory utilization, temperature, and disk utilization. We'll also see how you can create these templates yourself later in the video. You could mark one of these templates or any new template that you build as your default view. You can also see the different MIBs that are enabled for these devices. Few custom charts are also kept ready under these MIBs. For example, the IF MIB has charts specific to interface statistics. In this case, we have chosen the charts that shows top 5 interfaces for ingress and egress throughput. There are also charts where you can compare the interface statistics between the devices as seen here. Like we discussed earlier, we can also select multiple such charts together and create new templates, and it'll appear in the templates section. You could even make this your default template as well. ATOM also allows you to create your own custom charts. For example, you can choose the different metrics under these MIBs to create basic charts like these. Here you can combine them into a single custom chart as well by choosing the relevant metrics from the drop-down. We can also choose the chart type based on query, where the chart type could be a line graph or table, or it could be a pie or bar chart as well. We can then write queries against ATOM's database based on the KPIs you want to monitor. The queries can also have variables in it. So here we can see the line chart that got generated. For the same chart in the tabular format, we need to set the columns that needs to be part of the table, which will then give us the table representation. We can have the same chart represented in a pie or a bar chart format. If we choose pie as a widget type, we get the pie chart, and if we choose bar as a widget type, we get the bar chart as shown here. The charts can be downloaded in multiple formats and can also be cloned. We can also zoom into the charts to get more details on your KPIs as shown here. The variables can also be exposed outside as a global or local variable to address specific use cases where user input is mandatory. The metrics and templates available can be used at a device level or even at a network level. The charts can be pinned to the main dashboard or can be downloaded in the various formats listed here, and that includes a tabular report format as well. The data can be visualized at various time intervals, or you could choose a range to get the historical data. To summarize, Anuta ATOM's Network Monitoring Analytics module gives network teams in-depth insights into their network performance and aids them in troubleshooting any issues in the network. The collection capabilities also form the foundation of ATOM's alerting framework. Thanks for watching.